About a month ago, I did a community post polling you all, my viewers of Samcraft on YouTube, asking you, those who know, what is the best turnkey business quality 3D printer out there on the market as of today. The number of votes and responses I got from that were fantastic, and there was a clear, definite winner. What I have for you today in this video, guys, is that winner. This is the Bambu Lab X1 Carbon 3D printer. So guys, let's go ahead and jump into rolling the footage of the unboxing and assembly, which to call it assembly is not really assembly. You're putting pieces together that are super easy. But while this is rolling, I want to give you a little bit of backstory of Sam's history of 3D printing. I purchased my first 3D printer way back in 2010, which is 14 years ago at this point. It was a printer bought name brand, laser cut wooden, very much a DIY, almost ref wrap style printer, and was a really, really cool thing to play around with, but ended up being a waste of time and money. Mainly because 3D printing technology at that point was very, very, very young, pretty much in its infancy. I'll go ahead and overlay some photos here. You'll be able to see what I had as far as a setup back then. We have the printer, the power source, the filament, and random bits and bobbins as well that kind of went along with it. So that was a fun trip down memory lane, but today's video is really about the Bambu Lab. So let's go ahead and take the assembled printer. And now let's build myself a new 3D printing corner in my workshop. All right, fast forward a couple of days, and we are here at a corner of my workshop which previously housed my CNC machine. Don't worry, it has not left entirely. It has just moved from the new shop into the old one, which has become kind of the dirty shop. That's where my sanders are, my drill press, bandsaw, table saw, and now CNC. So that is the traditional, we're gonna get dusty, dirty shop, and this in here is becoming the clean shop where I do all my work. Laser engraving, etching, embroidery work, 3D printing, and whatever else comes down the pike in the future. This black shelf is not new, it is not pretty, and it is a little wobbly. But my plan for it is to repurpose it, recycle, and upcycle this into my new 3D printing station. I'm going to do some creative stuff with this. I need to make it fit the space better, make it stronger and more rigid, and then honestly, just fit the bill to keep my personal bill low on investment for dedicating this corner to 3D printing. I have the shelf reconfigured and made into what I want. The main thing I wanted was as many shelves as possible while still having at least two shelves to hold my larger clear tote that I use for filament storage. So the bottom shelf, the second shelf from the bottom are good to go. They then leave me with a little smaller shelf there for the top, but that's okay. It'll be a great place to put smaller parts bins or whatever else and just add another shelf so I don't have a lot of dead space. My next step is to get some plywood and cut it to fit to give myself a nice sturdy top for this shelf. Then we can go ahead and start fitting it against the wall, attaching it to my wall so it is very rock solid, sturdy, and does not go anywhere. And then we'll attach the top and pretty much be done with this project to bring the printer over and start loading it up. We'll be right back. And that brings us to this, the corner of the shop that is now 3D printer land. Previously, this is where my CNC was living on its table, but as this workshop has evolved and my business has evolved with it, this whole shop is now what I consider a clean space. So there is no woodworking, sawdust, or messy tools in here at all anymore. Those are all over in my old workshop, or what I call the tiny shop. All right guys, bear with me as we get in up close and tight here. We're in a corner anyway. So the 3D printer is running because if it's not running, you're not making money. So any kind of noises you hear, that's this guy. So right up front, a little bit of a tour. This looks kind of like a mini fridge. It is an all enclosed printer. It has a glass front door. You can open and close it as you want to. It also has a glass lid that you can take off. Whenever you print with certain filaments, you want lower temperatures inside, so you may be prompted, actually you will be prompted by the machine itself. Hey, temperature inside's a little bit high, open the door, and it's really cool because it helps give you successful prints, which is the name of the game. So up front, you got the door, you have a full color touchscreen. It does swivel this way, and so here you can press it. You can see the current job that is running. It tells me the percentage of the job, how far along we are. We're currently at 59% completed. It tells me what layer it is on out of total number of layers and all sorts of great information right here. This printer also has built-in memory as well as a micro SD expansion card so you can load and save your files here, making it to where you don't need to get on a computer or app or anything like that to run files that have been sent to the printer. You can just run it as is. I don't have this physically connected to my computer, and honestly, I have sent print jobs to this from my phone, from my computer in the house, and from the computer here in the workshop. Using the Bambu Studio application or their app is amazing. Okay, I'm geeking out. I've geeked out for a long time with this, so I'm trying to keep the geek level low. But having the ability to control this, to run jobs, see the status of jobs, and also pull up a live video feed from inside the machine as it runs from my phone, from my computer, is just amazing. It really is. So all right, so that's the machine itself. What you see sitting up top is called the AMS system. It's basically a filament housing box that will hold up to four different spools per AMS unit, and it automatically does color changes and feeds filament in and out of the machine. This system does have the ability to connect, I think, four of these together to a printer, so you could have up to 16 different colors for one printer, which is amazing and really, really cool, because that is not only technologically awesome, it gives you the ability to do much more complex prints, multicolor prints, and be able to walk away from it, right? So it handles all the color changes, all the purging and everything, so you set it to go and you go do something else. This is a wonderful machine to just be automatic. You can set it and forget it and do something else. That's why I really think this machine is business quality. This is the one. Obviously you all recommended it, you knew this already, but this is the one to start a business from. If you can at all swing it, you will never regret it on this one. Okay, now we're gonna get to the meat and taters of this video. Probably the reason you clicked on it. I'm talking about launching a business. I am advertising or saying this video is this printer, a new business, blah, blah, blah. So of course, you're wanting to know, Sam, what are you making? What are you starting for your business? What do I print? How do I start a 3D printing business? So first of all, let me go ahead and let you know the disclaimer that you probably already know. I'm not an expert at 3D printing as a business. I have had my own business for about 6 years now, so there are basic business fundamentals that definitely carry over. But as far as 3D printing, I'm not going to come at you as I'm an expert of 3D printing. Listen to me, I know it all. Because I don't. No one does. Not even those who advertise it. So with that being said, here's some basic advice as far as what I'm going to follow and what I would say to follow as far as, okay, you got a 3D printer or you're looking to get a 3D printer. How do you connect to the dots? What do you sell? And turn it from an expensive box in your shop to an income producing source. My advice to you is to find something that you're good at, that you like to do, and that has a need, and find out how your 3D printer can integrate. So you've got, let's say for example, embroidery, okay? Sam does embroidery, he's got an embroidery machine. There are specific things in the embroidery world that I have identified that, I haven't seen this out there. If I could make it, I could sell it, I could market it to other people with the machine that I have or the embroidery as a whole. Yes, there's products that I could sell. So in this instance, I've designed something that replaces a part on my embroidery machine that allows a person to further customize and change their advertising aspect. It's a very niche thing that I don't exactly want to say because I don't want to give it away just yet, but it's basically a way for someone, let's say Sam of Samcraft has his machine and he wants to do marketing, advertisement, and promotion. He may want to change something about it. Anyway, that's about as muddy as I can make it, and how horrible of me to hang a carrot on a stick and say, ooh, you're not going to see it. So anyway, just take the thought of something specific and run with it. So the beauty of 3D printers is you can literally create anything you can think of. So all you gotta do is think of it, right? Yeah, easier said than done. All right, on the realm of what beans Sam will spill as far as 3D printing products, I'll show you guys something, right? I'm not gonna be that mean to you. So if you follow my channel, you know that I have sold test files, jigs, fixtures, and everything of the sort as far as digital downloads. You make them, you follow along with my videos, and you're good to go. Well, having a 3D printer inherently leans itself towards what? That's right, you said it with me, making your own jigs or fixtures. What I have here is one of about 20 different unique jigs that I've already designed, made, and produced for the xTool F1. This one happens to be a luggage tag jig, so it is designed for a specific style luggage tag with different options, mounting options, abilities, and everything within. The beauty of the X1 Carbon with the AMS system up top is that I not only have, yes, the object itself, but I have double colors. I have two color printing, and I have my labels, my brand, my device information, my jig information rather, everything all in this. So this is one example of a specialized product that you could make with a 3D printer and sell. This is also, I guess, a soft launch or a little bit of a, hey, guess what guys? Sam now sells xTool F1 3D printed jigs for a lot of different items. My goal is, I'm starting with about 20, but I have purchased a lot of other objects from a lot of manufacturers to custom make jigs. So anything I've seen out there that people are engraving, I'm going to make a jig for it. At least that's my goal, as close as I can get to it. There are a lot of different materials out there. To bring it back full circle, guys, this is the first video of many from my shop showing this 3D printer. If you know me, you're thinking, wow, Sam's got some serious ADD going on. He's got laser engraving, laser cutting, embroidery. Now he's got 3D printing. Well, just know that this is probably not the end of the rabbit hole for me, or rabbit trail, or rabbit hole down the rabbit, whatever. It's not the end, because I myself do like to diversify new stuff, but also a big portion of what I do in my shop and with this channel is to also show you guys how to do things with new technology. If I can get something like this, show you the benefits, the drawbacks, how I use it, how I don't, how it pans out, or how it's a great success, that in turn is a benefit for you. The motto of Samcraft, I don't really say it much on this channel, but I think it's on my website, is basically empowering and providing information to you guys, the fellow small business owner or side hustler, to take things further. That's what I like to do. I'm a share, a show and tell guy. I don't hide behind walls. What is it called? Gatekeeping or something? I don't know. I'm an open book, and I like to share with you guys things that I learn. So that being said, this is a new one. This is a new video, first one out. If you've got things you want to know, questions you have, ask them. You're not gonna hurt my feelings. You just may not get a reply. No, but seriously, if you've got content ideas for 3D printing, let me know. Same thing for embroidery, laser engraving, laser cutting, all of that stuff. I don't just make this channel to hear myself talk, and I don't just make content that I myself only want to make. I want to make content that resonates with you. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging around with me this long. If you made it this far, leave a comment down below. I don't know. Wambu Bambu. There you go. I know you're super awesome. Otherwise, take care. I'll see you guys next time in the workshop.